He's had a nice little knock there. Let's see what that turns into, if anything at all. Would be nice, wouldn't it? See it rip off. Might have been a liner though, you don't know. But it beeped anyway, so. Because I've changed the sensitivity. Normally I have my sensitivity, so it gives about 2 or 3 inches before I get a beep. But the thing is, if you're somewhere, let's say for instance, you're away taking a crap, and you can't see your indicators moving, all you can do is rely on the sound, then you need every single sound to, every single movement to register, so. We'll see what happens. See if that's something that picked it up or what. I'll leave this going for a couple of minutes again. See what happens. Here we go again. They're not running though for some reason. They're just picking it up and just sitting there. Look. He's just sat there rather than striking. Yeah, he's on. Right, 15 pound 4, mirror. Middle rod again, as you've seen. An absolutely stunning creature. Lovely condition. See if I can get him out and let him have a look. Fins are up and he wants to play. And there he is, 15 pound four. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at him, lovely creature. He is. Place him back now. Come on. Camera's on. See if we can get a foot. And having the blood whale. So. Whoop. See if we can get a decent picture.
Where did you catch him on?
Peter?
Where did you catch him?
Where?
No, with what bait?
What bait? Bloodworm and krill.
Krill? Yeah.
It's from sticky bait. See if we can get another one then. Whee! Alright, okay. Come on now. Okay. Okay, you put it back then. Get the rod back out. Sometimes you think to yourself, I've got a monster on here. You know what's happened here with them, other indicators there, where they've just gone beep, 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 beep. They haven't gone for a run or anything like that. Pick it up, strike into it, nice fish, no doubt about it. This thing, one beep and then blazed off. So, got it under control, sorted it out. Where did it go? In the snags. And as much as I tried to control this thing, it just wasn't having it. It wouldn't come in, it wouldn't do anything. It wouldn't do as it's told at all. So much so that I went in the water, up to my bleeding shins, because it went in the snag and I tried to get it out of the snag. But no. So there it was, caught in the snag. I had to put the rod back on the rod rest. Walk round there, pull a bleeding great half a tree out of the water. At the end of the day, it's not all about just catching the fish, but I don't like the idea, where I can help it, to have fish swimming around the lake with a rig in their gobs and out, you know what I mean? 30, 40 yards of line hanging out the side of them. I could not believe it when I put it in the net. It's 10 pound, 8 ounces. So I've had a word with it. And I've put it in the picture. There's just no need for any of that sort of malarkey at all. I'll give you a look at it right now. Have a look at it. I'm shocked. You right? Can we have your photo? Come out here and show the people what you look like and what you did. Yeah? Yeah. Come here. Don't start that. No need for any of that. And you know it. Here it is, look at that. £10.08. I'm gonna have a photo of it. Cause I'm gonna have to dry out my trousers and everything like that. Right, old song and dance. Aren't you, you little monkey? Right, I'll get a picture of you now. And then you're going back. Yeah, all right, okay. Yeah. All right, you got nothing to be scared of. You're okay. Don't believe it. Bonkers. Absolutely bonkers. Some of the big ones don't give you half the trouble that these do they sometimes? Absolutely outrageous. Let's see if I can get a picture of it. £10.08 of nothing but trouble. One more. Can't believe it. Come here. Come on. Last one. We can go back. Right. Okay. So I'm going to put it back now. Before it starts giving me any more jip. God. I'm glad nobody ever got that on film. That was a right laugh. Well, it would have been for somebody else. But anyway, fish is a fish. And I don't care. They're all the same to me. But when you think some of the trouble that some of these little ones put you through. Some of the big ones, they fight really well now. But they come in, don't they? But these little ones, they don't want any of it. They're rebellious. So, put it back. And by the way, just a quick one before I do put it back. It's in water, okay, so it's being looked after. That was the left-hand rod, the one that I shifted from that overhanging willow tree over there. And I stuck it straight across the lake there, that far margin where I've been pulling fish out anyway. And I've dropped it in the margin around about, what would I say? 15, 20 metres from the other bait, because they seem to be having it from there. Because I'm not getting any answers or indications from anywhere else, except over there. Not even over there by the snags, I've had nothing. So that's where it's come from. It's only just over an hour in there, and that's it, off it goes. Okay, let's get it back then. Let's crack on, let's hope we get some more. Till then, all right? Don't believe it. Pain in the ass!
Don't tell your fucking mates what you did either. Go on, off you go. Go on. Yeah, so he's not to it, is he? Get under the water. That bloody shark. Waving to that one.
Cheeky monkey. Right then, two on at once. We've got one in the landing net down there, and this one coming first, obviously, weighs 20 pounds, 5 ounces. It's a mirror. It's got a horrific mark on its left hand side. I don't know what's done that to it. I'm gonna put some stuff on it in a minute. I'll let you have a look at it anyway. As soon as I got this one in the unhooking mat, off went the other rod that's been sat there all day doing bugger all. But who's complaining? However, that one is significantly smaller than this one. I'll pull that out in a minute and let you have a look at it. And I'll try and see if I can show you the mark on this. There, there's a half a pop-up. But anyway, let me just show you this. First of all, I'll show you this side. I'll show you this side of the fish, which is absolutely stunning. There you go, absolutely lovely. There she is. Right, look at that. Now what I'll do, turn the fish around. Well, that it is. So that treatment out in a minute. And I'll show you the other side. It's an absolutely horrendous mark. Look at that. There she is. Got her above the mat. Look at that mark. So I'm going to treat that in a minute. In the meantime, let's have a photo first. A couple of shots first. Fish just sat there in the net, all at home. It's light, just trying to get a couple just in case. Okay. It's alright. See if I can get some stuff on this. Treat this fish. I'm not going to put it back like that at all. I really do hope you heels from that. Not going to waste any time with it now. I've had it near long enough. Even though they're in water, you still try and get them back in the lake as quick as you can, don't you? Okay. Let's go and sort this out and I'll be right back with the other little monkey. Look at that one.
Away.
And it's treated, which please just be knowing. Great stuff. Yeah, thanks. Bloody hell, it hardly seems worth it. Clear this up. This little thing I'm hooked. Aye. Ooh. Yeah. Careful, isn't it? Through the bottom. Good deal. I'd have done that better if I'd gone down there and done it myself. Come on. Cute. We'll not complicate matters. I'll show you this one quickly. It's only a small thing, about 5-6 pound. We'll have a quick look at it and then we'll put it back straight away. It's been sat in that net down there. Yeah. Come on. I'm going to put you back in a second. Be good. Behave yourself. There you go. A cheeky little monkey like that. 5-6 pound. That's all it can be. I'll get a quick photo of you though. Come on. Not going to wipe it off. I'll do it again. Oh no, it's on the lens. You monkey. One more try. Right, that's it, you're off. You're off. Have that out of there. You're going. It's all right, don't worry about this, because I haven't got any rods left in the water. Because I had a similar one earlier on. I left the rod out. And so, right, I'll have a bacon and egg sandwich, which is currently sitting over there on my chair. Calm down. Because that rod went off right in the middle of it. And then just as I got that one in the landing net, off went the other bugger. So, what I'm going to do now is put this back, switch things off, and go and finish that, and then I'll get them back in and sort them out. Okay, back with you shortly. I hope, anyway. Let's do something about that sandwich. Well, there's the rods, much as we left them a couple of minutes ago. Just want to show you now where the rods are. I mean, the middle rod is where I actually put it to start with, which is actually there, right there. The left rod. I'll just pan out a bit there. Is there. Right there, next to that swim there, you can see it at the edge of that bush. And the right hand rod is there in that bush, just in front of it, not in it. You know what I mean? A couple of rod lengths out, because there's fish crashing about all over the place there. Obviously, they're up near the snags, but I chose not to fish near the snags this time. Don't want to fish near them. Not this time anyway. And so far, as you have seen, we've had about 8 fish. And I don't think we've done too bad. 7 that you've seen, 1 I released straight away. You know what I mean? It was only a small thing. It wasn't worth, you know what I mean, getting it in the unhooking mat, getting in the weigh sling, weighing it and everything like that for the couple of pound that it was. Alright, so I chose not to do that. I just, excuse me. And just left it and released it straight away. And then they had them 2 others, and I just had to get that other one out, and I just said like 5 or 6 pound it had to be. Easy. You know what I mean? I put it back straight away, but bloody hell, what a nightmare that was. But there you have it. I mean, there's only a few minutes left on this battery. I'm going to have to renew it and put another battery in. It's not a bad sesh, is it? I hope you're enjoying the blog. Kept me alive anyway, bloody hell. Did me tits in earlier on. I just didn't have a rod in the water. I was in the middle of me lunch. I had 2 rods in the water then, but I was in the middle of me lunch. And then the next thing you know, one goes off and then the other goes off. In normal situations, you pray for things like that, don't you? And I was knackered at the end of that. So I just finished me Sarnie. Got the rods back out. Another one jumping out. Got the rods back out. And then did some bivvy admin because my bivvy looked like a bleeding grenade had been thrown in it. You know what I mean? Sorted that out because apparently it's meant to be nice tonight, but from around about 5 o'clock in the morning, it's supposed to bloody absolutely hack it down. So waterproof jackets in the bivy. I spilt some dip on my leg and it must have been there a while. Been itching like mad. Anyway, waterproof's in the bivy. Get the cameras in later on. Rigs are all sorted for later on to be changed over just in case we get a run. No, that's a mistake. When we get a run. But yeah, we're good to go. I will admit, yeah, I am. I'm absolutely knackered. But there you have it. Came here to fish and that's what we're doing. Only got tomorrow and tomorrow night. Off back home, sort of like, well, I'll be back home by midday Saturday. So hopefully, I'll have a couple more out before then. Lake's like a bleeding piece of glass. Sometimes it's nice, sometimes it's not. You like a little bit of breeze on the water, don't you? Well, there you go. Yeah, just a quick one. All the rigs that I showed you right at the beginning. Come over here. Bleeding monster. Black as the devil's waistcoat. All the rigs that I showed you when I got here on the table there. I've used every single one and every single one has produced. You know what I mean? Every single one's worked, should I say. Yeah, I haven't had any hook pulls or anything like that. So I'm really pleased about that. Stiff rigs, braided, just normal nylon, all worked, everything. Just the normal bottom rig, liner liners, blowback rigs, they've all worked. So there you go. It's down to preparation, I think, and the way you tie your rigs and everything like that. And I'm not preaching to the converted or anything like that, I'm just making a point, that's all. So that's it, there we go. Okay, we'll leave it at that then. And if anything else happens, I'll blog it, you can be sure about that. It's going to be quite a lengthy one, this, I think. It's quite a few good bits happened, didn't there? You know what I mean? So I've got to get that online, got to let the boys see that. Because old Ben, he makes cracking blogs, he does. And don't get me wrong, we're not competing with each other. Nobody's competing with anybody. It's just to show you how we do it fishing. I don't think I could compete with Ben anyway, he makes some great blogs. Got it nailed right down. I just like to show you what we're doing. He does as well, but he does it in a more professional manner. I mean, so anyway, that's that. Hopefully Ben will be here tomorrow with Rob. We'll see what happens. Any more fish? I'll let you know, alright? Stay tuned. Catch you later.
Which one was it?
Middle rod. Okay, middle rod. Out there where I showed you earlier on in the bush. This time 21-1.
21-1.
21 pounds, 1 ounce. Exactly. Right, two other guys here watching me, two German fellas. Right, watching me do it. What a nightmare. Anyway, let's have a look at it. It's a mirror again. But for a fish this size, you'd think it was more than 21 pound. Roll it over. Just give you a quick look at it before I do a photo. Here we go. There she is. 21-1. can only just see my head, can't you? 21-1, she's ready to go. 21-1, lovely scrapper, excellent run. Flew off like nobody's business. So hopefully now she will let me take a photograph. Come on. Just check that quickly. Make sure it's all right. Yeah. One more. Okay, that's it. Let's get her back in the water.